All right, legendary drummer Carl Palmer has a long history with the National Center for Missing and Exploited Children. He's done several benefits on their behalf.
And happening, his latest is happening this weekend. He'll be at the Water Street Music Hall Saturday night.
Yeah, and I got the details from Palmer himself. We Skyped with him while he was in London. Here's that interview. All right, Carl, thank you so much for joining us.
You're more than welcome.
So, what do you think? Couple days, you're going to be on a plane heading to the United States. You'll be in Rochester on Saturday. What do you think about the trip?
Well, you know, it's just something that has to be done. I've been coming to America since 1968 was my first trip, so I've been coming every other year since then. So for me, it's always exciting. It's the mecca of my career.
Well, I think you said that really the U.S. helped bolster your career. Obviously, you come from England. You had some wonderful bands there.
Yeah, absolutely. And I first came over in 1968. I was with a band called The Crazy World of Arthur Brown. And we had a number one single and album at the same time called I Am the God of Hellfire. So, you know, I've got a lot of experience there. And I'm really looking forward to coming back. I'll be back again at the end of the year, November. I'll be putting on a 3 to 4 week tour with my Carl Palmer's ELP Legacy project.
And before we go forward, I just want to address, you are helping out the Rochester, New York branch of the National Center for Missing and Exploited Children. The profits, the money coming in is going to that organization. Why choose them?
Well, to be honest with you, I'm involved with a couple of organizations. This particular organization was put forward to me. I hadn't actually been involved before, so I thought this was a good time to start with a new situation. And it's been picked up via my lawyer, Bob Brenner, in Rochester. And we talked, and we figured this was the best one to go for. I'm involved with cancer research. I'm involved with the Heart Foundation of Great Britain. So, I get involved with a few charities, and I thought this just seemed appropriate, you know, at the time. So I'm hoping I can do some good for them.
What's interesting about the concert is you're going to take songs from ELP, you're going to add a different flavor to them, but also the artwork is an interesting piece. I was looking at the pieces online. It's an interesting take on your own movement and lights and all that. Is that going to be included in the performance?
We haven't included it yet, but we do actually include some of the slides, some of the actual artwork itself. The actual process in making these pieces of art is quite complicated. And, you know, for one painting, for one canvas, could take up to 7-8 hours to achieve. And it's kind of a hit and miss thing, really, because I'm basically trying to control light, the way it reflects, the way it falls, the way the sticks travel through the air. The sticks actually have small LED lights in them, and that's what causes the actual shapes and the images that you see. So I have to capture that with a very slow camera speed, shutter speed. It's then fed into a computer, and I take a look to see, you know, what's there, what we can do with it. And as I say, it's a good 7-8 hour day to try and get maybe something, and maybe you don't get something. So it's technology at its very best, and it's involving music and a new art form, really. This is the second catalogue that I've put together, so it's not new anymore, but from the advancement on the that we've made from the first collection to this, it's obviously it's way up there. The Rhythm of Light collection is something quite I'm really proud of it, actually.
Obviously, you're known as one of the better drummers of our day, really coming to prominence in the 60s and 70s. Do you feel like people who come to see you will see the Carl Palmer of old, or have you been advancing, evolving, that type of thing?
Well, I've been a working musician all my life, so I'm always getting better. Very fortunate to say that. There's not quite a few of my friends that I played with over the years who, you know, didn't get better, and I feel sorry for them from that point of view. But I've got a very simple philosophy. At the moment, I'm still improving. I'll carry on playing whilst I'm improving. I'll carry on playing if I can maintain a standard. If I can't maintain the standard which you'll see in Rochester or Buffalo or wherever I'm going to be, then I will stop. But at this moment in time, I'm still there, you know, thanks to some great doctors that have kept me on track. And I've been well looked after and I've been blessed. So I'm extremely happy to still be playing today.
Great. My last question, folks who come out who are huge fans of ELP, do you think that they'll hear a lot of what they want to at a concert?
Yes, of course. I'm trying to play as many things as I can from the past. You know, I'd like to, it is nostalgic. I do like to take people down memory lane. All I'm doing is I'm just playing it in a different way, not using keyboards, using guitarists, using guitar players. And for me, it's just giving it a different twist, making it a little different for me, and just trying to get it across to a wider audience, because the demographic that I play to, you have to understand, normally is between 40 and 60. And over the last 2 or 3 years, I've seemed to have picked up a lower demographic from the sort of 20 to 30 year old. So I hope that we can carry on doing this, and maybe guitars instead of keyboards is a way to do it. You know, the keyboards were the 70s, and that was Emerson, Lake and Palmer. This is Carl Palmer's ELP legacy, and this is just slightly different, but with the same message.
Great, while also helping out a wonderful organization here in Rochester. So I know that a lot of people are looking forward to your visit and your concert.
Yes, I'm looking forward to helping the these children or whatever can be done for this organization. And for me, it's an absolute pleasure. It's nice to be able to give something back.
Well, it's been an absolute pleasure to interview you today. Thank you so much for your time.
No, thank you very much. It's been a great pleasure. Thank you.
What there a we go. Wonderful guy.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Just a right sensational drummer, too. Mm-hmm. Yep. Mm-hmm. So anyone who goes to that show will, I'm sure, be pleased.